All right. Hello, hello, hello. So I saw a streamer playing this game, a streamer that I like. I didn't really look at the gameplay. I just saw the game title and I was like, huh, what is that? I looked it up. And it looks really, really cool. Kind of like a hidden gem sort of thing. So I'm gonna go in 100% blind, besides knowing that this game is a point and click, like a murder mystery investigator game. And that's literally all I know. So I'm just gonna jump in and we're gonna start playing it. I'm not streaming this because I know how people can be when they come in for games like this. They'll probably spoil shit. So we're just jumping in. These are gonna be pre-recorded. And we'll see how it goes. This game is called The Case of the Golden Idol. That must be the idol right there. I think I'm gonna do with highlights because I don't want to just be clicking literally everywhere on the screen. And it's their recommended experience, so let's do that. What's going on here? Whoa. Kind of just jump right in here, huh? A tobacco pouch and a pipe cleaner. Two bags filled with coins and gems. A bag of medical instruments and some medicine. I'm not gonna read all these. If I read something too fast in my head, just like pause and you can read what's here. Any golden statues found? Oh, I can grab names and stuff. Interesting. Let me try without highlights. Does the cursor change? The cursor changes, so I might be able to just go without the highlights because I can just hover instead of having to click. Yeah, I like this better. We're gonna do this. It's easy to just be able to kind of hover and see what's going on. Okay, so green shirt thinks this other guy was plotting something. Can investigate while he's falling. Scalpel. So it's the same contract. So Oberyn provided the map. Albert is the funder. Doctor and Esquire. I don't know what Esquire is. So this is the map. Horned thumb, horned finger, Xenopolis. This guy has a medicine bottle, medicine bottle and a scalpel. So the fallen guy must be Oberyn because he's got the medicine stuff. So the Oberyn is the doctor. Albert is the guy who's pushing him. This is the funder. Okay. So what's this? Oh, okay. So identities. So we know the fallen guy is Oberyn, I believe. Because he has the scalpel and stuff, and he's a doctor. So Oberyn Geller is the fallen guy. This is Albert Cloudsley. Okay. So Albert Cloudsley pushed Oberyn Geller from a cliff in the... I think it said where they were. Coins and gems. So this is Cloudsley's pack. And this is Oberyn's. He gets the statue. Okay, where was my map? They're at... They can see this in the distance. Right? They see two islands in the distance. So they must be... At the Horn of Thumb? Yeah. From a cliff in the Horn of Thumb. No hints accessed. First case solved. While Dr. Oberyn Geller was surveying the poor weather with his looking glass, his expedition partner, Albert Cloudsley, Esquire, suddenly pushed him off the cliff. Well, there's still more slots. Camp in... Oh, I think it's just Horn of Thumb again. Everything is filled in correctly. 11 out of 11. Okay. Now what? Okay, there we go. So that was scenario one. So these guys went to those ruins, I suppose. One of them had a golden statue. And the rich guy pushed him off the cliff because of it for some reason. Complications in the family. An abrupt termination of contract. Okay. What's this? Okay. Okay, next is number two. The untimely passing of a rural gentleman. Okay, so this guy gets murdered in his bed. Here's the idol. God is slowly floating. Spontaneous combustion. Sebastian Cloudsley. So this is a guy from the rich family. Dining attire. Researching attire, oh boy. From researching attire back to dining attire. Roast duck into beef loin. So we like to hunt. So he's researching something. This might have been the day he died. Went to bed at 10:30. The 22nd. Today's the 23rd. Okay. So he was murdered like 10:30 or sometime during the night between the 22nd and 23rd. Is that a self portrait? Kind of looks like it. Some kind of head wound. Okay, I clicked all those. There's, for some reason, there's a book about lead poisoning pulled. This guy had a ring with a ruby. It looks like he was injured elsewhere. And he came in here to bed and laid down for some reason. Okay, let me see what I know. So this is Sebastian Cloudsley. This must be his dining attire. This must be... Oh, that's actually a good question. What did the diary say? I guess it's his dining attire. Or no, it must not be. Maybe it's research because he said he was doing some research. And then hunting. Okay, so it's this. Hunting and then research. Okay. So he's three sets of attire for some reason. Sebastian Cloudsley, Lord of... What is this place called? This was the map. He sees water, so he must be Lord of Blackfield. Passed away in his bed. The cause of death was a head wound, which occurred when he fell from a, I guess it's his horse, while he was hunting. Okay. I think that's it. 16 out of 16. So this guy, I'm assuming all these deaths are going to revolve around the statue. Duh. This guy maybe felt like he was getting betrayed because this guy had the statue. Whether he was doing it of his own volition or because he was like influenced by the statue is not clear. This guy got a spontaneous... What the fuck is going on here? Spontaneous head wound. Just while riding a horse. Years old. Okay. Oh. The dramatic departure of an outsider. So far, everybody who has had the statue in their possession has died. This guy had a horse brush and a knife. Oh, the blazes. This guy had like a horse race ticket. It's like Trogdor. Interesting. EC, maybe another Cloudsley. This is EC, maybe. It's got a handkerchief that says EC on it. Edmund. This guy gave a speech, I guess. Oh, the idol can be used to cast magic. He has the ring now. So it's that circle with a blue gem. Okay, so that's the same spell. But who did he kill and why? Okay, so this must be the stable boy. So David Gorman is the guy he killed. So this is the Batley house, because that had the symbol above the door. Pear twins. Is that? So Albert married Mary. I'm not sure what this symbol is. They had Edmund, Rose, Sebastian, and Beatrix. Okay, I might need to come back to that one. Feeling scared is a weakness. Be strong instead. Wow. So useful. What the f- Dear Willard Wright. Rose Keeper. So burnt something. We see the gold statue. Ah. Okay, I got all the clues. Okay, so this is like some killing over the will or something. Let's see what we got here. Okay. Let's start with identities. Mm-hmm. of your family. Okay. Okay, so we know this guy is Nicholas Mocker, the attorney. Let's start there. So Nicholas Mocker. We know the guy out here is Edmund Cloudsley because of his kerchief. Also has this symbol above, which was, what was that? Oh, it's Batley. They're in a Batley house, so this must be, she must be a Batley. She must be Beatrix Batley. First name? Oh, maybe not then. It's the Batley house. Come back to her. So the guy getting burnt is the stable boy. David Gorman. David Gorin is the guy getting burned because he's a stable boy. This guy has an A on his knife. For tomorrow. Oh, maybe this guy is the... This guy is David Gorin. Oops. I was simply following orders. Perform the combustion ritual. Who is that? This is starting to get tricky. Okay, let's start here. All right, let's reacquaint ourselves and go over here. We met so rarely after you left for colonies, therefore I bequeath to you my savings, land in the Blackfield Manor House, come home and establish a museum of life and accomplishments. I want you to put your sharp mind to better use than mere politics, therefore I bequeath to you the notes from the research I have undertaken on astronomy. I grant you leave to finish and publish it under both our names. My late sister, your mother, disclosed your financial troubles to me long ago and I resolved to help you. I bequeath to you a compilation of my aphorisms to provide the direction in your life which you clearly lack. So this is a sister of Cloudsley. I bequeath to you the golden idol of Xenopolis. You'll know what to do with it. So she is a Cloudsley. But which Cloudsley? Maybe it's on here. Oh, she's married now. Late sister. So this is Sebastian's will. His late sister would be his older sister, I believe. I mean, it would make sense if this was Beatrix Batley. But I don't have Beatrix. I don't have that name. What does it mean for somebody to be a late sister? Let me Google that real quick. I think that means that maybe that's younger sister. Wait, what? Late mean you late? Well, I know what late means, but what does it mean for someone to be a late sister? Man, these Google results are dog shit. What is a late sister? That's all I want to know. Fuck. I don't know. Google was useless. Okay. Addressed to Willard Wright. What does body ear mean? Body ear is Sanskrit? What the fuck does that mean? I mean, I know Sanskrit's like a language or whatever. Alternative spelling of the Sanskrit word bodhira, which is defined according to... what? It means something in Hindi. Okay. Deaf. Okay. Deaf sometimes. Who can be deaf sometimes? So this guy must be one of these. He's either Adam or James. Do we have today's date? This might be this September 7th, 1786. I don't know if I need to look up like what day that would have been. That doesn't seem right. Plugging in and see. September 7th, 1786. That would have been a Thursday. So if it was a Thursday, that means Adam was doing horse grooming. So Adam is the guy that's on fire. I don't know his last name though. And this guy, I mean, his knife has an A. Maybe he's Adam. Oh, his knife has a J. Okay. Okay, so I didn't need to do the looking up what day it was in 1786 thing. So this guy has a knife that says J. So he is James. This is Adam. And then they're probably the Pear brothers. Adam and James. That makes sense to me. Adam Pear and James Pear? I don't know. I don't know what the fuck this is supposed to be. What else? Okay, let's go back to this will. There's different. Oh. This might not be right. We met so rarely after you left for colonies. Museum of my life and accomplishments. Okay. Notes from the research. Okay, so somebody should have the research notes. This guy, I guess. Yeah, because he was researching spontaneous combustion. I need to figure out who this guy is. I still don't know his name. £35. There was one over here too. Doesn't say whose it is. Dear Peter Batley. So maybe she's a Batley. Shit. He has debts. Dear Brother Edmund. See that part in here. Dear Brother Edma, and then there's nothing else. This game got really hard really fast. So no, this is Edmund. This is the coachman. This is the lawyer. I don't know why they're burning the Pear brothers. Said they were following orders, but what was it they were doing? I guess this is one of the guys I got bequeathed something. He likes watching horse races. I mean, I don't know what that changes. Okay, so we know Sebastian Cloudsley's sister. Got the aphorisms or whatever. I saw those somewhere. It's on the ground. So it's either Rose Cubert, we have that full name, or Beatrix Batley. We don't have Beatrix. So I guess it's Rose Cubert. Is that who she is? Maybe we don't know that's who she is, but we know this is supposed to be Rose. AR Rose Cubert. Oh, it's just deer. Who left for colonies? And what does that mean? What the hell is colonies? There's something missing on the wall here too. His late sister, your mother. Why does it say your mother? Inheritors all present, so we know all the inheritors are here. So Rose is here, Willard's here. Okay, so this must be Rose. I mean, this guy literally has the golden idol, so maybe we should just assume that's the one he gifted it to. He didn't say who he gave it to, though. Maybe we're supposed to assume, I don't know. Why are there two different Raging Sultan, Spinning Jenny? This is supposed to tell us who this guy is right here. He was inside. Maybe he's the, he's a Batley as well. So he's probably Peter Batley. That's my guess. We know this is James and Adam. I don't know if they're the Pear Brothers. I don't know what else they would be. This guy was given the golden idol, so maybe he's just Willard Wright. Where did we see the name Willard Wright? He is an inheritor? Let's just see. Willard Wright. Ooh. Bang. Okay. So we have identities. So that must mean Willard Wright gets the golden idol. I mean, he literally has it. It said she had financial troubles, which this might be that. I mean, it says it's Batley's debts, but whatever. Okay, sharp mind to better use than mere politics. Who would he tell to make a museum to his life? What the fuck? Sharp mind. Notes from the research I've undertaken on astronomy. Okay, maybe somebody has those notes. Than mere politics. Well, this guy has this letter, so Edmund Cloudsley must be the politics guy. And he bequeathed his lands and everything. We met so rarely after you left for colonies. Left for colonies? Come home. So this must have been whoever Peter... or whatever his name was, whoever Sebastian was married to or something. Wouldn't be one of his sisters. I don't have any names left. Maybe this is just Peter. It's Nicholas. I don't know. Fuck. How else can I figure this stuff out? This is definitely Willard Wright because he knew what to do with the idol. He had the notes. Financial troubles. It's his sister. Batley has the debt. Doesn't say who he's married to or anything, though. These are the inheritors. Okay, so the four check marks are people who inherited stuff. So Willard Wright definitely got the idol. Rose is his sister. And I don't have the first name, so it must be her for the my late sister. This one must be Edmund, so I just have to figure out what this last one is. I don't know, time to guess. Two or fewer slots are incorrect, so this is correct. So one of these is still wrong. What if it's Rose Battley? Somebody took the thing and burnt it. Wait, who was it that spoke? Yeah, Edmund Cloudley. Okay. What if I do someone else here? Then it's definitely wrong. So this has to be right. I think, or at least one of those is right. Okay, well, what's the fourth name I haven't used? Right, it's just an inheritor. So it's Rose, Edmund, Willard, and Peter. Okay, so this guy, I guess this must be Peter. Fuck. Rose, Edmund, Willard, and Peter. Maybe this is Rose, and then this is not? This doesn't make sense, though. What? How is Peter his late sister? Oh, god damn it, I'm stupid. It's Dear Peter Battley. I thought he was addressing the... He said, my late sister dash your mother. Peter's mother is Beatrix's. Okay, yeah. His late sister, which means, I guess means his younger sister. She came later. Okay. So, he gave his land and everything to Rose, his sister. He gave his research to Edmund, his brother. He gave Peter. That's so... He gave him such dog shit. He had financial trouble, so he gave him aphorisms. Okay, he did not like Peter, I guess. And then Willard. Yeah, Willard is an associate, I guess. Maybe a descendant of the guy that got pushed off the cliff. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so James Pear to take the maybe idol. Probably from Willard Wright. I think it's Edmund was upset to receive research in Sebastian Cloudsley's will. So Edmund was upset to receive the research in Sebastian Cloudsley's will and ordered Adam Pear and James Pear to take the idol from Willard Wright. Suddenly, James Pear died from spontaneous combustion. Okay. I tried. Okay, so what was wrong here? There's no way Peter ordered anything. He doesn't look like he's... Yeah, he's surprised. Oh, you know what? Okay, I bet he did the ordering. Okay, so this guy, Peter Batley, was upset to receive aphorisms. Yeah. Peter Batley, encumbered by his gambling debts. Okay, that's why Sebastian didn't like him. Had placed high hopes on his uncle's testament. Upon discovering he had inherited nothing but a book of aphorisms, he tore up the will and ordered his servants to take the golden statue from the stranger Willard. Okay. Suddenly, one of the servants burst into flames. Okay. So originally, Albert Cloudsley pushed Oberyn off the cliff. This guy just randomly died. Probably because of the idol. I mean, this was a Cloudsley. Chapter 2, The Cursed Inheritance. The murder at the Little Mermaid. Okay. I hope I haven't been blocking shit with my camera. I always forget to think about that. I'll keep an eye on it. For a couple days in the old oarsman's place down at the docks. This guy must have done the killing out there. Empty bed. Trap door. Door does not open. That's weird. Revenge. I Beast Master. Oh. This might be Willard. I attended our departed brother's send-off. Oh, the dead guy isn't Willard. Proud Beast Initiate. Okay, so the guy that's saying I have attended was Willard. So Clousley was part of some weird old cult, it seems like. He gave them the idol. He gave the Brotherhood the idol. I shall send this letter tomorrow, September 10th. I hope it will reach you without delay. Already it is midnight. I will retire to my bed, for this has been a long day. May Griffin awaken. Proud Beast Initiate. So the initiate is writing to the master. This guy must be the master here. Ticking watch. Stab wounds to the chest, or stomach, I mean. Okay. What the hell is this place? Little Mermaid Inn. Was Ash. That looks like the escaped convict. Kind of a banger. Sheet. So this is amazing, Evan. Just gonna find the last clickable thingy. What am I missing? One thing left. I'm lacking critical information. What the hell else? Else. All right. What am I missing? Clicked all these. Clicked all this stuff. All the information now. Identities. All right. This is Oscar Boyton. This is Amazing Evan. Robert Redruth. That is Henry Parker. This is Willard Wright. John. Okay, so this guy's John. One drink. Okay, so that was Ash Blair bought the drink. Poor Annie. Still doesn't tell us what her name is, though. Never gamble with something so dear to me again. John B. Edge, because we know Blair's upstairs. This guy is something Evans. M.E. He got fucked. So it's Maurice Evans. Agent of the Trading Company. Annie Green. This other guy must be WW. Oh, Willard Wright gambled. I guess he's not WW. That's Maurice. AG. Annie Green. JB. John Breach. OB. This one must be Blair. What? No. He didn't buy a drink. Deliver it to me immediately with the servant boy. Left. Died with 3 stab wounds. Okay, so forget me not as Ash Blair. Okay, so Ash Blair did the killing. So Ash Blair crept into Willard Wright's room through the trapdoor. Wow. John Breach and Annie Green and Oscar Boyton. We're playing cards with loud music. A fight ensued upstairs, and Willard Wright got stabbed with a dagger. Oh yeah. Okay. I didn't know the music box is what woke him up. I actually didn't put the pieces together that he tried to frame the other guy either. Okay, I think I can get one more in. I'm gonna switch to something else. All right. Nice place. Little Pip. Ash Blair tobacco and a bottle of gin. That must be some code talk or something. Discarded syringe. Shit. So Edmund has the idol. Thank you. Peter. He's that guy. Love potion. Okay. I missed four clickable things. I'm gonna do one more once over and then maybe turn on the little click hints. That's interesting. All that. Got all that. Oh, the gold ones? Okay. The gold ones are new things. Oh, here we go. Okay. Now we have all the pieces of information. I already know this is Edmund Cloudsley. This is Peter Battley. Is Rose Hubert. This is Little Pip. Chick is something Richards. Mary Richards and Lothar Richards. Okay. Lucia. Brian. Blair Tobacco, David. Wait, who's David? Oh. Oh, David isn't here. Okay. So that's a junk name. Where is he? The tobacco there. Maybe the kid took one. So it's lemonade, basically. Okay, so partially eaten was her because it's in her mouth. So, Rose Cubert. Has the partially eaten salad. Oh, but I don't know if she had the lemonade. I figured out these ladies' names. Oh, Baker. So she'll be the one cleaning. Okay. Ada Baker. is she doing? Stirring some bowl. Walker. She's the cook, so it must be Smith. Okay. Lucia wants candles. This is David. I think. Yeah. Okay, so this room is David's. Top floor must be hers. Must be Ada Baker's. Because she has the candles. She's probably the one that's worked here the longest. Or no, maybe she hasn't. I think Brian has. Because he's the oldest. That's my assumption. What is that room? Oh, that is think somebody wanted him and Cloud sleep dead, so they poisoned the tonic. I think that's the one, the peptic tonic. I guess it could have been the brandy too. I don't know, actually. Let's not jump to conclusions yet. Well, we know Rose Cubert died. So the wine is not poisoned. Brandy could be. She was eating salad though, so the brandy cannot be poisoned, actually. So either the lemonade or the peptic tonic is poisoned. I don't think, I think it's the tonic that's poisoned, actually. Tonic. And then the tonic is in the blue key room. Probably just Ryan. Because it was like down with our lords or whatever. This is in Brian's room. Down with parasites. Actually, I don't know. Shit. How do we know who wanted who dead? They want to ship. Sebastian, whatever his name is, to the colonies. Fourth one from every row. Maybe that refers to one of the letters? Thank you. What else can I figure out? Edmund invited them, so this is Edmund's house. I was thinking he probably sat at the head of the table. Why wouldn't he? Somebody poisoned the peptic tonic, trying to kill him. Vanguard? I don't know. That's technically a thing. Who is Final Vanguard? He was asking for a raise, he wouldn't want to kill him. So Brian Walker is definitely not the poisoner. Whoever's in the top room poisoned him, I guess. Ada Baker? Why is she Final Vanguard, though? Fourth one from every row. Not sure what that means. Fourth one from every row. Let's just say Ada Baker. I don't know. Okay. He is like two bumps and then a long one there. Okay, so it's definitely this key. So whoever is staying in this, I don't know if it was whoever's in that room, but the key is definitely the one in the bag. Just ate a baker twice? No, it can't be. Figure out David's last name. Oh, it's Walker. Okay. Or not. NB. There's no NBs here. The fuck? Oh, so close yet so far. I'm gonna have to step away for a little bit here in a minute. So when I do, I can just skip ahead to where my camera is again, and I'll solve this. I have like 2 more minutes. Who would have wanted Edmund dead? Maybe. No, I don't think it was Brian, but we can try it. Yeah. He wanted to ask for a raise. Fourth one from every row. What is that referring to? What am I missing? This must be her seat. Rose Kubert. This must have been Mary Richards. Peter Battley would be the meat-only guy. Who the hell else was sitting here? Oh, Lothar. NB. There's no NB. Nobody has a name N. Huh. I mean, this must be Brian's spot. It has to be. And then this is... David, what was his name again? David Goron, yeah. Oh, Brian is already here. Whoops. So who was here? Ash Blair. This is David. That's David Goron. Who's the secret person? Okay, I have to step away. We'll solve this in just a minute. Give me a, maybe 5-10 minutes or so. Just skip ahead to where my camera's back. Back in a little bit. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, finally back. Sorry for that holdup. All right, let's get to the bottom of this. So there's some person in here who has this monkey man shit. A couple of keys that... This has to be the new, like, stable guy they just hired. NB is whoever lives in this one, but I don't have an NB. NB. Or is it the opposite? That's probably this one. Yeah. So I still don't know who lives there. Look at who these were addressed to again. Edmund. Maybe the steward was living there without him knowing? Unleash one of our stewards upon you. Is it Vanguard steward? Masks steward? No. It's Final Vanguard? No. Let's just say this. Okay, so it is this top two that's wrong, I think. Who the hell lives there? Striped dark hand. March 1788. So he invited them on April 8th. They got the letter like a month ahead of time. And then he was warned by these guys. It's January, so this is a long time ago. One of our stewards. Brotherhood of Masks. But I don't have, like, Brotherhood as part of the clues. Oh, maybe this is little Pip's room. There we go. Why does he live in such a little shit room? Poor guy. Oh, that makes sense. That's why he's reading the little kid books. I thought these were, like, written by the person for some reason and not just, like, actual books. But then who wanted it and dead? No way, it's little Pip. Yeah. Could have been George Bridges, I guess. Oh. Shit. Who wanted Edmund dead? Could have been a lot of people. Oh, you know what? It's the butler. No, it's not actually. So Ada did it. Oh, David Gorin wanted him dead. That's the answer. Wait, really? Was it Brian Walker? Shit. I don't know. Not Peter again, is it? Yeah. I don't fucking know. It couldn't have been Mary. Literally just going through all the names. Wait, what? Oh. I've gone through like every name. What is it? I don't fucking know. Final Vanguard. Where'd Dark Hand come from? That was in here, wasn't it? I'm about to just give up. I don't fucking know. Use substance to remove target. Sincerely, Dark Hand Steward. Dark Hand Steward. That's why that letter looks so weird. 8 of Baker received encoded instructions from Dark Hand Steward to poison Edmund Cloudsley. She used her ability to move freely throughout the rooms while cleaning and made a copy of the key. Yeah. She used a syringe to poison the sealed peptic tonic bottle. However, during the party, Rose asked for tonic and drank it first and died. Okay. Nice. That was tricky. Alright, that's going to be it for this time. See you guys in the next one. I really hope my camera didn't block much. It seems like I can't really put the camera anywhere without blocking something. So I'm hoping I was just blocking, like, some of the keywords at the bottom middle. At worst. I hope I didn't block anything else. But yeah, anyway. Till the next one. This is pretty cool so far. I like solving mysteries like this. And I like that so far it's been intuitive. You haven't had to like use a ton of outside knowledge or something. It is a little cheesy that you can kind of guess your way through it. Like that second to last case that I just did. I didn't even get half the story about like the guy getting framed and all that, because I was more focused on just like which clues fit where. But yeah, it's been really cool so far. Looking forward to more. Till next time.